these levels, it's way off of where they were last Thursday.
Yeah, they sound a lot better.
Okay. I don't trust the Jabrones at all.
No.
That's right.
Coming to you live from Tyne Davis Gymnasium. Coming to you live from Tyne Davis Gymnasium. We'll try this again. It is a Saturday noon tip here in an SSAC matchup between a couple of schools affiliated with the Churches of Christ. Makes it a lot of fun for Florida College and Faulkner University. Faulkner, David, we talked about it. It's a team that, despite the Bethel game, which is the outlier, has been in every game during this losing streak and just has not been able to finish.
Yeah, and that's been the common theme. They've been there. Had leads in those games of good size in some situations, and just one of those things, you've got to learn to finish a ball game and close it out. And it's
right.
Part of a developing as a team and as a player individually.
How much of that is confidence do you feel like for this group? Which, granted, they've lost two all-conference players since the beginning of January, but you have to feel like there's some degree of confidence that's the issue here.
Yeah, anytime you have something like that, it's going to be an issue with confidence. And when you come out on this court, just knowing you're without two really good players, it's going to affect you in several ways.
We'll talk a little more about this here in just a moment. We'll pipe you in for the opening prayer and the national anthem and the starting lineups.
Come out and enjoy this event. We pray that you would be with both schools today to help them to play to the best of their ability with great sportsmanship. We pray that you would be with the coaching staffs and be with them as they set the right example in front of their teams all throughout the week and through the season. Lord, we thank you for those that have traveled here today. We pray that you will protect them as they travel home. But most of all, Lord, we thank you for Jesus, who walked on this earth and lived a life for us to set an example for us to live by. We thank you that he chose to die on Calvary so that we could live eternally with you. In your son's name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
National anthem.
Starting lineup, first of all, for the visitors from Temple Terrace,
Dunn,
Florida.
And now Dean Kelly
Florida College
brings the starting
Lady Falcons. A 5'9" sophomore guard from Atlanta, Georgia, number 3, Audrey Judy. A 5'5" freshman guard from Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania, number 4, Riley Everett. A 5'11" junior forward from Cottage Grove, Wisconsin, number 10, Kaylee Henson. A 5'6" junior guard from Gainesville, Florida, number 23, Lauren Moore. And a 5'11" freshman guard from Bald Knob, Arkansas, number 25, Kinley Varnell. Lady Falcons are coached by Jacob Rourke, assisted by Amara Mills and Taylor Rourke. And now the starters for your Faulkner University Lady Eagles. A 5'9" junior forward from Athens, Alabama, number 0, Channing Gafford. A 5'9" senior guard from Hartsell, Alabama, number 2, Kayla Harbin. A 5'7" junior guard from Locust Fork, Alabama, number 24, Ashlyn Atkins. A 5'8" sophomore forward from Thompson Station, Tennessee, number 30, Olivia Colson. And a 5'8" sophomore guard from Troy, Alabama, number 34, Michaela Fasanik. Lady Eagles are coached by Reed Sutton, assisted by Joel Harrison and Kayla Tillman. Student assistants Lindsay Sykes and Jenna Berglund.
And the starting lineups are in the books. We are ready to tip here at Tyne Davis Gymnasium between Florida College, enters at 9-11, 2-6 in SSAC play. And the Lady Eagles of Faulkner University entering in today at 14-11. Jeremy Smith alongside David Turner for the call here today. Kayla Harbin will handle the tip opposite of Kaylee Henson. And there's the opening whistle. We'll get this one underway here momentarily. Faulkner will control the tip. Ashlyn Atkins with the basketball across the timeline. She works it to the right to Kayla Harbin. Harbin will bring it back around left to Michaela Fasanik. Fasanik on the deck to Colson. Colson's got to get the ball out of there. Gets it out right wing. Harbin back up Fasanik. She'll work over to the left to Gafford. Gafford, Fasanik, 10 to shoot for the Lady Eagles. Back over right wing. Colson, 3, won't go. Rebound fought for by Harbin and an early foul call.
Good effort, good hustle. Just over the back of the box out there, and that'll get you the call every time. Without the box out from the defender, that's a clean play.
Into the front court comes number 25, Kinley Varnell. Gets the ball over to left wing. That's Andreana Judy. There's the attack from Riley Everett. Passes back off Varnell. Varnell left wing. Into the lane, banks it in. Nice take off the hand of Kaylee Henson.
Strong take by Henson into the teeth of that defense. Puts up a tough shot, manages to get it in.
Colson on the block. She'll bring it back out, get it to Fasanik. Fasanik, Colson. Back over right wing, Gafford gives it back to Colson. Reset, 11 on the shot clock. Fasanik will fire that three. Count it for Mickey Fizz. Faulkner with a 3-2 lead, 8:44 to go here in the first quarter of play. Across the timeline comes Kinley Varnell. She'll attack, now handball off Riley Everett. Back over to Varnell. Everett again. Left wing, Lauren Moore, 3, won't go. Kayla Harbin had the board. It was slapped out of her hands by Kaylee Henson.
One of the interesting matchups in this game is going to be this Florida College team. Their three-point percentage defensively is top 10 in the country, and this is a Faulkner team that likes to shoot a good bit of threes every game. So that's going to be an interesting little cat-and-mouse game between these two teams.
So we've switched it here. It was Faulkner ball. Now they've reversed it, and they'll say Florida College ball. Now they're going to talk about it. Harbin had the ball in her hands on the rebound. Varnell, or Henson rather, slapped the ball out of her hands from behind. Now the decision is who touched it last, and they're going to say off of Henson. So Channing Gafford will inbound the basketball to Ashlyn Atkins. She'll come across the timeline. Gets it back over to Gafford. Gafford to Fasanic. She'll put it on the deck.
Good pass.
And a nice cut by Atkins and great defense from behind by Kinley Varnell trailing the play.
Good play all around. Nice cut from Atkins. Good feed from Fasanic. But even better defense there to block the shot out of bounds.
Atkins to Fasanic, brings it back around. She'll split the defense, bounce past Gafford. Had a look, I think, at the basket and brought it back out. Harbin over right wing, Atkins six to shoot. Goes right wing over to Fasanic, dumps it down and stolen by Andreana Judy.
Lazy pass inside, knocked away. And
layup won't go. Fasanic, the rebound coming the other way. That shot, I think, missed off the hand of Henson that time. Fasanic dumps it down to Colson. She'll pivot, attack, all the way to the basket. Lays it in with the right hand. 5-2 is the lead for Faulkner. Varnell gives it up left wing. This is a Florida College player that doesn't play very many players' big minutes. Nice spin into the lane, but she a little too strong off the shot for Kaylee Henson. Colson will grab the rebound. She'll bring it into the front court. Right wing Fasanic down into the corner to Harbin. Harbin will attack baseline, kick it into the corner. That's a three from Channing Gafford, won't go. Colson, the rebound, brings it back around, gets it to Fasanic. There's Atkins. She'll reset. Fasanic into the corner, 12 to shoot. Brings it back out. She'll give it up to Atkins, slapped out of bounds by Florida College. 7 on the shot clock. David, when you look at this Florida College team, you've got 6 players who average 8 points or more per game. And then the 7th player averages 1.9 per game. So you see where the minutes go for this Florida College team.
Yeah, and that's good. They spread it out with those 6 players. As Olivia Colson makes a strong move to the basket, spins to that right shoulder or into that left shoulder and puts it in.
Liv Colson with a couple of buckets early here in the first quarter. 6.5 to go in the frame. Varnell working with the basketball, goes left wing Riley Everett. Everett back up. That's a three from Andreana Judy, won't go. Kayla Harbin with a tough rebound. She'll dribble it out herself and lead the break. Brings it back across, throws it over to Colson. Tipped alive by Andreana Judy. Judy will press the issue. Fasanic back to stop ball. Everett will dump it back out to Judy. Skip pass across to Lauren Moore. Moore back into the hand of Everett. She'll get it over to Judy again. Judy attacks to the elbow, changes direction, and caught Liv Colson off balance on that change of direction to get the foul.
Well, it was a nice pump fake by Judy. Gets Colson up in the air and in a precarious spot defensively. And takes advantage of it, goes to the free throw line, knocks the first one down.
Andreana Judy makes the first free throw. Second one is going to be forthcoming here. Judy, a 5'9 sophomore wing from Atlanta, makes both of them.
Atkins brings the ball up for the Lady Eagles. She drives right inside. Nice feed into Colson, has it blocked. And Florida College will bring it the other way.
Into the front court we go. Kaylee Henson gets the ball over. Riley Everett, the three. Atkins brings it into the front court. Right wing, Fasanic. Fasanic will attack. Sends it over to Colson. Colson dumps it down to Harbin. Harbin, skip pass. Gafford, three. Off rim that time. 5-0 run right now for Florida College as they work at right wing. Judy misses that one. Rebound for Sonic. We go the other way. For Sonic, skip pass. Atkins, escape dribble. Three. Ashlyn Atkins makes it 11-7. They'll call it a two, never mind. I'm confused here.
The scoreboard
was off 1 point. This is what we're being told now. So it was never 8-7. That was a lie. It was fake news, if you will. 10-7, we go the other way. Kayla Harbin gets it into the hand of Channing Gafford. Gafford, Harbin. Back over to Colson. Colson, hand off Fasonic. Fasonic attacks back out. Sends it over to Adkins. Deflected, corralled by Colson, and a foul. I think they're going to pin this one on Varnell. We'll see, and they do. That'll get Maya Gaston and Megan Wilkinson into the game for the first time, along with Alexis Canyon. Canyon, a 5'8 sophomore wing out of Warner Robins, Georgia, transfer from Andrew College. Ball comes in to Adkins, over to Wilkinson, back to Adkins. 10-7 lead right now for the Lady Eagles. Gafford hit hard from behind, loses it out of bounds. We'll see who they say it went off of.
They're going to keep it on that end of the floor, Faulkner basketball.
Harbin to Wilkinson. Back over to Adkins. She'll put it on the deck. Skip past Wilkinson. Back up to Adkins. Pulls a deep three and nearly knocks it down. Into the front court comes Alexis Canyon. Canyon in, back out, feeds it up to Judy. Judy attacks right hand, won't go. Rebound Maya Gaston. Hands it over to Kayla Harbin. She'll lead the break. Harbin to Gafford. Gafford into the corner to Wilkinson. Wilkinson attacks baseline, up and under, won't go. Rebound underneath by Riley Everett. Everett to Varnell. Varnell, three, won't go. Rebound Gaston. And a timeout taken by Reed Sutton. So 3:17 to go, first quarter. David, not a bad start for this Faulkner team. They're getting good looks at the basket even when they're not converting points.
Yeah, they are, and I think what Coach Sutton is wanting them to do, and he's getting this timeout for, is to get them to try to look to attack more, to attack the front of the rim and in this defense and move quickly. Don't let them get set up and keep you from those shots that you're looking to get. No substitutions either way.
Ten-7 is the lead. Ashlyn Adkins into the front court. Sends it over to Megan Wilkinson. Wilkinson back up to Gafford. Gafford dumps it down to Gaston. She regathers. Harbin to Gafford. Gafford attacks and a whistle.
Foul on Maya Gaston.
Gaston called for the offensive foul that time. Into the front court comes Varnell. There's Judy, gets it back over to Everett. And an illegal screen, so one offensive foul deserves another. So they'll call that one on Judy. Fasonic will go back in. We'll get Kayla Harbin out for the first time. Valentina Clocker will check in.
Adkins back up top, gives it to Gafford. Gafford goes baseline to Fasonic. She attacks, and she'll throw it away. Varnell on the steal. She leads the break. And blocked by Adkins.
They're going to call it clean. So Adkins with the block goes off of Canyon. Nice job chasing the play by Ashlyn Adkins. Comes into the front court. Adkins across the timeline will attack all the way in, kick it back out to Gafford. Gafford to Fasonic. Fasonic puts it on the deck. She'll attack, bank it in. Nope, won't go. Tipped alive and rebounded by number 23, Lauren Moore. Varnell sends it over, left wing. Three, good, off the hand of Andreana Judy.
Adkins brings the ball up for the Lady Eagles, kicks it right side to Fasonic.
Fasonic goes baseline, back out. Wilkinson on the attack, feeds Gafford. Gafford, left wing, Adkins, three, good. 13-10 is the lead with 1:41 to go here in the second quarter. Varnell sends it over left wing. Gets it to Moore. Moore, Canyon. That won't go, and then Will.
No real rotation defensively out to Canyon, and she's able to get a clean shot.
Atkins, right wing, Wilkinson. Wilkinson feeds Clocker, left wing. Gafford pulls the three, won't go. Rebound underneath by Riley Everett. She'll push the issue into the front court. Goes right wing, Canyon. Canyon kicks it back over to Everett. And tipped out of bounds. It'll stay with Florida College. Harbin checks back in.
Canyon looks to inbounds for the Falcons. Right, great inbound pass to Varnell as she's cutting to the basket. She lays it up and in for the Falcons. Gafford splits the defense right down the middle, and she's going to get fouled. Fouls on number 23, Lauren Moore. Her first foul here this afternoon.
Channing Gafford shooting the free throw. That one's up and good. Second one good. Fifteen all is your score. Inbound to Varnell. Varnell, skip pass. Right wing to Henson. Henson over to Canyon. Canyon will lose it out of bounds. It'll stay with Florida College. There's the handoff to Canyon. Canyon dumps the ball to Everett. Everett and a foul call on Florida College. They will call it on Everett. Inbound will come to Atkins. Atkins into the front court, gets the ball over to Harbin. Harbin on the deck, handoff Wilkinson. Wilkinson to Harbin. Harbin, handoff Colson. She'll attack all the way in. Right hand won't go, but a travel
first.
15 all is your score. Varnell takes the inbound. Varnell into the front court with it. She'll attack, send it across. Into the corner, tipped out. Harbin will come away with it. She'll heave it at the basket, aware of the clock. The end of the first quarter of play, 15 all. Faulkner and Florida College. We pause on the Faulkner Sports Network. Fifteen all is your score. Inbound will come from Canyon. Gets it to Andreana Judy. Judy hands it off to Varnell. Varnell sends it over left wing Riley Everett. Everett back over to Henson. Harbin will come away with the ball. She pushes it into the front court. Skip pass. Adkins in the corner. Gathers, attacks. Back over baseline. Valentina Clocker misses that shot. Rebound underneath by Kaylee Henson. Henson pushes it into the front court. Sends it over right wing. Andreana Judy. Now down into the corner. Back up into the lane. Layup right hand good by Varnell. Adkins with it.
Varnell got inside the lane there. No real opposition as she made her way through the defense.
Coulson to Harbin. Harbin to Adkins. Adkins dumps it low to Coulson. Coulson back out. Harbin, three, no good. Rebound underneath by Judy. She'll bring it out of there. Gets it to Varnell. Varnell on the attack. Kicks it over. Now back up top. Swings it left wing. Kanyon. Dumps it to Varnell. That three, good. 20-15 is your score. Adkins into the front court. Adkins, Harbin, left wing, Clocker. Clocker attacks and a foul call. They'll call it on Judy. That's two on her, I believe.
It is. You start thinking if you can get foul trouble on some of these players from Florida College, only playing really seven ladies, that could take a big toll on them through the course of this ball game.
Absolutely. All right, lineup changes here. The new five for Faulkner is going to be Gaston, Harbin, Fasonic, Gafford, and Adkins. Also see Whitney Eccles coming into the game for Florida College, a 5'6 freshman guard from Longmont, Colorado. Inbound comes to Fasonic. Fasonic works around to the left, hands the ball off to Ashlyn Adkins. Adkins, left wing tipped out by Kanyon. Harbin will inbound the basketball. Gets it to Adkins. Adkins, right wing, Fasonic. Fasonic attacks, and look at the lane open up for her as she floats it in. 20-17.
No rotation defensively. Fasonic gets right into the middle of it, able to get that floater up over the outstretched arms of the defense.
Judy hands the ball off. There's the attack from Kanyon. Kicks it. Mid-range jumper drops from Judy. Into the front court comes Adkins. Hits Fasonic right wing. Dumps it down low to Gaston. She'll kick it into the corner. Harbin, three, in and out. Rebound fought for, controlled by Varnell. She'll lead the break herself all the way. Dumps it to the left, and that basket good by Henson.
Basket by Kaylee Henson. Timeout. 30-second timeout.
Kaylee Henson makes it 24-17. You're going to get a 30-second timeout by Faulkner. And, David, it feels like Faulkner still getting good possession, still getting good looks at the basket, but not getting stops on the other end's the key.
Yeah, and that's the thing that's really going on. They're getting some pretty good looks. I don't think they're still not attacking quite as much as the coaching staff wants them to, but defensively is the big problem right now. They're not getting those stops. They're not getting back quick enough defensively, getting set, doing those little things that it takes to really get a stop defensively where you can get going the other way.
Into the front court comes Ashlyn Adkins. She'll send it over to Fasonic, dump it down low to Gafford. Gafford, jumper in the lane, drops it. Nice job by Gafford that time. Cuts it to 24-19. See if Faulkner can get some stops. Florida College shooting 47% from the floor right now. Judy drains that three. They're now shooting 50% from three. Adkins into the front court. Over into the corner. Three won't go. Rebound Harbin. Back to Fasonic. Head fake. Puts it on the deck. All the way in and a foul. 27-19 is the score. Fasonic will take two free throws here. That one's up and good. Go, 27-20 is the score. Second one up and good. Across the timeline comes Varnell. Back over right wing. She'll feed a cutting Everett. Everett, Varnell, three, no good. Box out by Colson, gets the rebound. Colson into the front court. Right wing, Fasonic, head fake, all the way in, lays it up, and no good. Rebound off the hand of Canyon. She'll turn around and grab it, lead the break the other way. Canyon, pull up in the lane, good. 29-21. Adkins into the front court. Attacks, loses. Gathered by Gafford off of the tip pass from Harbin. Harbin in, bounce pass. Colson, turnaround layup, good. 29-23. Faulkner got to get a stop.
Good possession off the broken play. Harbin gets right inside defensively, makes a great pass to Colson.
Varnell with it, works over right wing to Moore. Moore back over to Henson. Left wing Everett sends it over to Henson. Henson, right wing, there's the attack up top. Now left wing Everett. Everett over to Varnell. Varnell back over to Everett. Spins, blocked by Ashlyn Adkins, and a shot clock violation. So Adkins with her second block of the game. Gafford inbounds the ball to Adkins. She'll bring it into the front court. Adkins. Over to Gafford. Gafford, handoff Colson. Colson works right. Gets it into the hand of Adkins. Adkins to Fasonic. Dumps it down to Colson. Turn around right hand, banks
nice.
It in. Colson, very effective. She's got 8 points right now. That cuts it to four.
And she showed good patience right there. Took the time to feel the defender. And then make her decision about where she's going with the basketball.
There's a mid-range baseline jumper. Won't go. Fasonic rebounds it. She'll dribble out of the traffic. 24 on the shot clock as she sets it up. Attacks right. Looking for a pass. Finds Harbin. Harbin to Gafford. Gafford pulls it. No good. Rebound underneath by Riley Everett. Everett will push it across the timeline. Gets it over to Varnell. Varnell down right wing. That three won't go. Rebound tipped out of bounds off of Canyon. So it'll be Faulkner ball. They get the stop this time. Gafford inbounds it to Adkins. Adkins across the timeline. She'll attack right off of Gafford. Dump it to Colson. Colson kicks it to Harbin. Harbin attacks all the way in, right hand left.
Nice.
Good. 29-27 is your score.
Good strong attack by Harbin, and that's one of those things that can happen when you've got Colson up playing that high post. You can make those times of cuts baseline.
And layup won't go, but a foul. They'll put it on Liv Colson. It's two on Colson. Free throw, back iron, no good by Henson. Free throw, back iron, no good again. Rebound by Gafford and a foul.
That one's on Varnell. She has two.
Gafford will inbound the ball to Adkins. Adkins across the timeline. sends it left wing for Sonic. She'll attack all the way in, and a travel called on for Sonic. 29-27 is your score. Wilkinson will check in a moment when we get the next dead ball. Varnell into the front court, hands it off to Everett. Everett hands it over to Canyon. Canyon attacks all the way in, into the body of Clocker, and a turnover. So that'll get Fasanic out and Wilkinson in. Clocker will inbound the ball. Adkins works to the left, gets it to Clocker left wing. Clocker pulls it, no good. Rebound underneath by Varnell. Varnell pushes the issue. Everett, three, no. Rebound alive, Clocker's got it. She'll take it herself and now stop. Gets it over to Adkins. Back to Gafford, three, good. Faulkner up 30-29.
Take that three on the secondary break there by Channing Gafford, and that's just a smart play by Clocker, not going out of control, just stopping the ball, giving it up to your ball handler and letting her make the decision.
Varnell goes to Canyon. Canyon has it knocked free. And Adkins and Harbin force the jump. Possession arrow, Faulkner, 2:19 to go in the second quarter of play. Gafford will inbound momentarily. She gets it to Adkins. Adkins across the timeline. Adkins to Wilkinson. Wilkinson to Clocker. Clocker, left wing, Harbin. Harbin. Bounce pass into Gafford. Finds a cut in Clocker and she can't catch it.
Turnover, but at least good action on the play to get that look there that was coming. It was open if she had that ball, had caught the ball.
You get that catch, it's probably an easy bucket right there. The attack, layup right hand, no good, but a foul. That's going to be Henson that absorbs the contact, and she'll go to the line shooting.
Harbin's second foul.
Shooting two now is Henson.
Change that to Channing Gafford. So that's her first foul.
It's one on Gafford. Second free throw. Good. So Henson makes them both. Florida College back on top, 31-30. 1:48 to go in the second quarter. Ashton Atkins into the front court. Hands the ball off to Megan Wilkinson. Pulls the three. No good. Rebound underneath by Varnell. She'll bring it into the front court with a minute 34 left in the second quarter of play. Varnell. And a whistle away from the ball. And there's a quick second foul for Gafford here. She's picked up two quick ones in the last 20 seconds of play. Varnell, face up with Wilkinson. She'll attack right, back left, gets it off in the hand of Everett, pulls the three, good. 34-30. Florida College right now 6 out of 14 from three.
We're pushing the bag on Florida College. The foul is going to be on number 22, that is Alyssa Buford.
Got a mini 5-0 run right here for Florida College. See if Faulkner can break it. Clocker to Harbin. Back over to Wilkinson. Swings it left wing. Adkins. Bounce pass. Gaston. Gaston back out to Wilkinson. Pulls the three. No good. Rebound underneath. Fought for and controlled. First time we've called the name of Alyssa Buford. That's Varnell with it. Working left. Defended by Wilkinson. Comes into the screen of Buford. Hands off Canyon. Canyon can't get it to go. Harbin with a rebound. She'll take it the other way. 11-second differential between shot and game. Long pass. Adkins misses the three. Varnell the rebound. 2-second differential between shot and game as Varnell brings it into the front court. She'll slow things down. Defended by Wilkinson. Varnell. 10 to shoot. She'll back it out. 6 to shoot. Pass over to Everett. She gathers, heaves with a second to shoot. Never hits the rim. Shot clock violation. 1.4 to play in the second quarter.
It hit the rim, so.
Did it hit the rim?
It
looked like it hit the backboard. So they'll say it hit the rim. 2 seconds to go. They throw it to Adkins. She'll pull it. Didn't get it out of her hand. 34-30 with two quarters of play in the books. 41.38% from the floor for Florida College. 40% from three. Those are the big numbers to look at. Faulkner's gotten good possessions. They've taken more shots. They are winning the rebounding battle, and the turnover battle is close, but it's, Dave Turner, it's the fact that they're just not getting the stops right now.
Just not getting stops, and they're not hitting those open threes. You look at the three-point percentage, Florida College hitting 40% of their threes, Faulkner hitting 23, and they've both taken 115 shots, the other 17. So they're shooting about the same number of types of shots. Just Faulkner hasn't gotten those to fall down for them. And then you compound that with, on the other hand, you're getting those runs where you're just not getting good defensive possessions and stops for yourself there to get you into that offense.
Faulkner shooting 36% from the floor, 23.5% from three. Florida College 41.4% from the floor, 40% from three. Points in the paint right now. Faulkner leading that battle 12-10. Off turnover, 4-0 for Florida College, but they're winning the bench points 5-0, as you circled there. It's when you're playing a team that really only plays six players,
yeah,
you feel like you should win the bench point battle, and right now they're not.
Exactly, and you're playing 10 different players, and you're losing the bench battle. That's a number that you want to circle, because that hurts. That hurts when you're expecting production from your bench and just really not getting it yet in this ball game.
Yeah, and that's the thing right now. You know, this is a Florida College team that usually only plays six players big minutes. They have played eight players here in the first half, and Faulkner has played eight as well. So we'll see if Faulkner can turn the tide here in the second half. We send it to the break. 34-30, Florida College leads in the Faulkner Sports Network. Florida College will have the ball to start the second half here, up 34-30. Hand off, Judy attacks, right hand good. Faulkner's got to get stops. That was the story of the first half. Email comes in from Linda McKnight, says, watching the Lady Eagles game in Limerick, Pennsylvania, just outside of Philly. Thank you, Faulkner Sports Network, for allowing me to see the game so far away. Go Eagles. Great to hear from you, Aunt Linda McKnight, Reed Sutton's aunt, always one of our viewers here. Gaffer, left wing, Harbin, three, no. Rebound, Colson. Really good box out by Colson.
It was. Great box out by Colson. Just maybe rushed that put back a little bit too much there.
Yeah. Left wing now. That's Lauren Moore. There's the attack by Henson and a foul.
Stop bailing around.
Colson gets that one. I think that's her third now.
Maya Gasson checks in. Liv Colson checks out. Henson with a free throw. No good. Second one forthcoming from Kaylee Henson. Henson, 6 points, three rebounds, and an assist today. Second free throw, no good. Rebound by Varnell. Varnell attacks. Left hand won't go. Rebound Fasanic. So Faulkner gets the stop. Fasanic ahead to Harbin. Harbin will attack. Now back out. Tipped alive. Fasanic can't gather it. The official takes a seat on the bench.
30.
So a Faulkner turnover here. That is the eighth turnover for the Lady Eagles. Ball thrown ahead to Judy. Judy back over into the corner. Varnell to Henson, left wing. Moore. There's Everett, Judy, Henson, Everett, all the way in, right hand, good. 38-30. Adkins into the front court. Fasanic left wing, back over to Adkins. Adkins to Gafford. Gafford up to Fasanic. Fasanic attacks. Harbin in, right hand, good. So Harbin, the first bucket of the second half of the Lady Eagles, cuts it back to a 6-point lead, and a 30-second timeout by Faulkner.
It was a strong attack by Harbin. Coming off the wing, she got the pass from Fasanic, just able to get by her defender, then splits the her defender and the post defender, and gets a nice layup, cuts this deficit just a little bit, down to six. But it's all going to come down to the other end, being able to get stops and make Florida College take difficult contested shots the rest of the way.
38-32, 8:01 to play here in the third quarter. Update from Harrison Field. The doubleheader between Faulkner and Shawnee State delayed an hour. Umpires were late arriving, so first pitch will be at 1 o'clock there. Judy jumper won't go. Rebound fought for underneath. There's Varnell. She kicks it right wing. Everett pulls the three. It won't go. Rebound by Henson. Gets it back over to Moore. There's the attack from Henson. Layup right hand good. 40-32 is the score. Adkins comes into the front court. She will spin through the defender, back out to Harbin. There's Gafford. Gafford to Adkins. Over to Harbin. She is hit by a couple of different people there at the elbow. They'll call jump ball. So Adkins will inbound it. We've got to get it in. They'll get it into Gafford now. Gaston pulls it. Won't go. Rebound underneath by Henson. Henson runs it into the front court. Gets it back over to Varnell. Varnell backs it out, face up with Fasanic. Dumps it over to Judy. Left wing, Now up to Varnell. Right wing, Everett pulls the three. It won't go. Gaston and Judy collide. Judy comes away with a rebound. There's Everett. Spins into traffic. Left hand won't go, and you're going to get a travel before the shot. Valentina Clocker checks in. Maya Gaston comes out.
Long offensive rebounds right now, breaking the back of these Lady Eagles, just giving up those long threes, and then they're just running and beating them to the loose balls.
Atkins to Clocker, finds Gafford cutting. She muscles it up. It won't go. Rebound Varnell. Varnell all the way in, slapped out by Clocker, and they're going to get her with a foul. Foul 40-32, 6:36 to go. That's the first foul on Clocker. It was 6:36 to go in the third quarter. Let me modify that. Second free throw coming from Varnell. She makes that one. It's a 9-point game, 41-32, 6:36 to go. Gafford will inbound it to Atkins. Atkins gets it over to Harbin. Harbin attacks, kicks, Clocker into the corner to Atkins. No. Everything but the net.
Yeah, everything but on that play, because it was a great pass from Clocker, just quick hit pass right down in the corner to Atkins, just not able to knock it down.
Atkins will inbound. Gets it to Gafford. She turns baseline and a foul.
Good quick decisiveness in the post from Gafford. Spins back inside to the lane.
Gafford will go to the line. She's got 7 points to this juncture. First free throw from Gafford is good. Gafford on the season, 59.6% from the line coming into this one. She'll knock them both down here. She's got 9. That is the high point for Faulkner. 41-34 after she makes both those free throws.
Good hands defensively by the Faulkner defense as Gafford brings it up into the front court.
Harbin attacks, kicks. Gafford, three, in and out again. Clocker with a rebound, and she's hit, and it goes out of bounds.
Foul number 22, Alyssa Buford, her third, team second.
Atkins will inbound it.
That was on Alyssa Buford.
Gafford, Clocker. Spins toward the basket and scoops it in. Valentina Clocker with a nice play. Cuts it to 41-36. Atkins, Harbin defend. Forced almost a trap there. Knocked free. Ball's loose. Varnell in a slap fight for the ball. And they'll get Clocker with a foul. You said it a moment ago, partner, but Florida College getting the most of the 50-50 balls right now.
Yeah, and look, that was good defense.
It was really good defense.
That was as much as you could possibly do without coming up with the basketball there by the Lady Eagles. Just one of those unfortunate situations. You're just ball's just enough out of reach. You guys can't grab it.
Everett, turnaround jumper, drops it. Email comes in from Tammy Hamilton. Says Tammy and Reggie Hamilton watching from Shelbyville, Tennessee for Maya Gaston. Great to hear from you, Tammy, as always. Gafford with it at the elbow, attacks toward the baseline, looking for some help, kicks it over to Harbin. Harbin attacks and loses it, but a foul is going to help out there.
I believe they're going to get that on number 23 for Florida College. They do. That's Lauren Moore. That is 2 for her.
Believe that she is the second. There are now 2 Florida College players with 2 fouls and 2 that have 3. So Fasonic attacks, gets it over Harbin back to Fasanik. Head fake goes all the way in. Nice, nice. Take. Michaela Fasanik versus the world, and she banks that one in, 43-38.
Good strong take. Had to go take the ball around the defender to get the shot up.
And you're going to get a foul away. That's Lauren Moore. She's got three. So now three Florida College players have three fouls. That's a tongue twister that I didn't expect. That's going to get number 24, Whitney Eccles, in the game. Lauren Moore will check out. 43-38, 4:43 to go here in the third. Ashlyn Atkins into the front court with the ball, goes right wing, Kayla Harbin. Harbin puts it on the deck all the way around and turns it over. I think they were looking to try to get Atkins coming off the screen, and the timing just wasn't right.
Yeah, she got ran into a defender and then one of her own players there in the mix of that, and it broke that play up.
There's right wing Henson. Gets it back over to Eccles. Now Henson again. Looking for help. Gets it to Varnell. Varnell sends it to Kanyon. And an offensive foul.
No, foul's on Fasanik.
No, Fasanik called for the foul.
Okay. Just her first foul.
First on Fasanik. Varnell inbounds to Kanyon. Kanyon back over to Varnell. Up top, Eccles, three, good. They are now 7 of 18 from three, getting back up close to that 40% mark. They called that a two. All right. Scratch all of those previous thoughts. Colson back over to Clocker. Gets it to Fasanik. Fasanik on the deck, all the way in, lays it up, and one! Mickey Fizz cuts it to 45-40, and she'll go to the line. So Fasanik now with 11 points. She's the first to double figures for Faulkner.
They're going to put that foul on Riley Everett. She now has two fouls.
So two on Everett. David, we've talked about this, who's going to emerge as your scoring options here, and we've seen Atkins and Gafford, but Fasanik is the logical one. And she's been averaging right around 12 in conference play.
Charge.
And there's an offensive foul. It's on Kanyon. That's her first foul. Gafford will check back in. Clocker will come out. This is the lineup that I'm interested to see here. Your starters back in at this late run, 3.5 minutes left in the third. It's an opportunity with some of the Florida College players in foul trouble to try to close this gap. Gafford over right wing Harbin. Harbin goes off the screen. All the way, lays it up, right hand won't go. Rebound tipped out of bounds, and they're going to keep it right here. So they'll call a foul on Eccles.
That's her first, and that's why you're seeing that Coach Sutton and his staff just scream every time. If you hear it, they're screaming attack, attack. They want their guys to get in, attack the paint, make those defenders make the decision to give up the shot or take the foul.
Taylor Jones will check in momentarily. Harbin's first free throw, no good. Faulkner's got to start making some of these here. They've been good on the game, 6 of 7 before this trip, but the way Florida College is shooting, you don't want to give up any points. Harbin's second free throw. That one misses. So Kanyon rebounds it. She'll run it into the front court herself. Nearly a travel there as the ball got up into her chest. And now she kicks it to Varnell in a three. So right back, you had a chance to cut it to three, and it's back to eight now.
Somebody lost track of their player coming back defensively. It's Fasanik attacks again.
Muscle it in there. The body control to be that far underneath the basket when you take that shot is impressive. And a foul now called on Everett.
That's three for her.
Three on her. You got four Florida College players with three fouls. Colson's going to check out. Taylor Jones will check in. Ashlyn Atkins, free throw, up, off iron, no good. Second free throw forthcoming. That one is good. 48-43. Varnell pinned down. She'll dribble through it. Down the sideline. Fasonic trying to stop ball, knocks it free, and then they're going to get Fasonic with a foul. That'll be her second. Joel Harrison there talking about the flaw in the setup of the defense because you almost had the trap down here, but she was able to dribble it right down the sideline, the last thing you want her to be able to do there. And then Fasonic has to rotate over late.
Yeah, you want to cut that sideline off as much as you possibly can. You want to use that sideline as an extra defender as Varnell hits the first free throw.
49-43, second free throw forthcoming for Varnell. She's got 12 points on the afternoon. Give her 13. That ties Michaela Fasonic for the game high. Ashlyn Atkins into the front court. Sends it ahead to Harbin. Harbin working right. She'll attack all the way baseline. Kicks it back up top. Fasonic, three, no. Rebound underneath by Andreana Judy. Judy into the front court. She'll attack, pull it up. Free throw line, count it. Back to a nine-point game when moments ago you had a chance for it to be a three-point game. Long pass into the corner for Sonic. Ball fake. Back over to Jones. Jones got to get it out of there. Back over to Gafford. Gafford working off a screen. Pulls the three. No good. Rebound by Judy. Judy will dribble it across the timeline herself. All the way down the lane. Kicks it to Varnell. She'll pull that quick three. It won't go. Rebound tipped alive. Atkins on the floor. She's got the ball, and I think they're going to go jump ball here. They're going jump ball.
And stay on that end of the floor.
Possession arrow, Florida College. It'll stay with the Falcons. Megan Wilkinson will come in. Michaela Fasonic out. 52-43. Florida College will inbound the ball on the baseline. Varnell gets it in. That's Moore. Sends it back over to Canyon. Canyon hands it off Varnell. She'll attack, kick. That jumper off the hand of Eccles, air balls. Wilkinson coming the other way. Gets it to Harbin. Harbin dumps it low. Jones can't run it down. It's a turnover. That's the 10th for the Lady Eagles. Michaela Fasonic will check in. Kayla Harbin checks out. Fasonic defending Canyon. Works right, sends it back left. There's the attack from Moore, and a foul. I'm going to put that one on Megan Wilkinson.
Just her first foul.
Get them together and demand more.
Moore, free throw, up and good. The lead is 10. It's where it feels like an uphill battle for Faulkner because they've executed for much of the third quarter and just didn't make shots in the stretch when they had a chance to really close that gap. And now Florida College has been making shots on the other end again. Their field goal percentage at 45% right now. And you talked about it in the first half. It's the inability to make the three is a problem right now. Faulkner shooting just 18% from beyond the arc. And there's a foul, offensive foul.
Illegal screen. Taylor Jones.
54-43. Everett into Canyon. Kenyon hands it off to Henson. Henson attacks, and there's another foul. It's on Taylor Jones. That's going to put Moore on the line. Free throw, good. Lauren Moore, 3 points on the afternoon. Lead is 12. Second free throw coming from Lauren Moore. No good, rebound Channing Gafford. Gafford comes into the front court. Gafford spins toward the basket, lays it up, left hand good. Nope, no good, I apologize. Colson fighting for the rebound. They'll keep it on this end. Atkins will inbound to Gafford. And a lot of contact, no call there. Gafford just falls down, I guess. It's a turnover, number 13 for Faulkner, number 12 for Faulkner. Into the corner, three, no good. Rebound by Fasanic. A lot of bodies on the floor. They got to take advantage. They'll throw it ahead to Colson. She'll lay it up good. The assist to Atkins. Colson with the layup. She's got 10. They cut it to 10. 17 to play in the quarter. Shot clock is off.
Good job passing it up and just going fast there with a sea of humanity on the floor on the other end.
There were three black jerseys down. Kenyon attacks in, and a foul called on Fasanic. No, they'll put it on Gafford. It's three on Gafford. Kenyon's first misses.
A 58% shooter on the season is Kenyon.
And that one's good. Pushes the lead back to 11 with 4.1 to go in the quarter.
Florida College going to give pressure, make this difficult play to run for the Lady Eagles.
Harbin throws it into Adkins. She'll dribble across. 2 seconds, it's blocked. Nice job by Florida College to block the heave at the buzzer. 11-point lead for the Falcons as we head to the fourth quarter on the Faulkner Sports Network. Fifty-six, 45. Florida College leads as we start the fourth quarter here. Harbin gets it in to Adkins. She'll come across the timeline, work right side to Fasanic. Fasanic all the way to the baseline, banks it in, won't go. We go the other way. That's Everett with it. She'll come back around to Vernell. 20 to shoot. Farnell gets it to Judy. Judy, three, no good. Rebound underneath Harbin and a foul. They're going to put that one on Henson. That's her first. Harbin will inbound. to Adkins. To Gafford. Hand off to Sonic. Back to Wilkinson. There's Gafford. Trapped down in the corner, out to Adkins. Back to Gafford. All the action's in that one corner, and that's where the defense is right now. And an offensive foul on Fasonic. That's three on her.
Like you said, the ball is kind of just stuck in that corner, going back and forth, one player to the next there on that part of the floor. They're able to get set up in their press, though, and see if they can get a deflection, steal, some kind of turnover here by this Florida College team.
Barnell across the timeline, defended by Adkins, gets it over to Canyon. Canyon to Barnell. Barnell attacks, kicks out. Everett, three, good. It's a 14-point lead now for Florida College. Or they'll call it a two? They called it a two. 13-point lead for Florida College. Fasonic to Wilkinson, over to Adkins. She'll attack all the way to the baseline, layup, right hand won't go. Foul called on Florida College. So Everett, it's four on her.
It is. First Falcon with four fouls.
So Adkins to the line.
And the Eagles with the opportunity to put some points on the board without the clock moving.
She's got 7 points. She'll hit the first free throw. Second free throw forthcoming. She makes that one. 58-47, 8:27 to play. Lady Eagles have had some 11-point fourth quarter leads of late in losses. Let's see if they can turn a deficit into a win today. Canyon across the timeline. Fasonic defending. Sends it over to Varnell. She'll attack right down the teeth of that defense. And an offensive foul on Varnell. That's three on her.
One step over. Charge. One step. Not that. One step over.
58-47. You've now got four Lady Falcons with three fouls and one with four fouls. Gets it over to Gafford. Gafford going on the attack. Gets it back out. Harbin into the corner for Sonic. Back up to Harbin. She'll attack down the lane. Finds Gafford. Gets her own rebound and banks it in. So Gafford's in double figures with 11. The third Lady Eagle to reach double figures. Judy kicks to Henson. Back up to Varnell. Swings it over to Moore. Moore to Canyon. Canyon on the deck. Back over. Judy will pull it. No good. Rebound by Henson. So the box out was absent on that shot. Varnell, Moore, three. You cannot give up that second chance bucket there. And Reed Sutton will take the timeout. His team had it down to single digits at nine. You got to stop. Nobody was present on the boards, and it turns into a second chance three.
Yeah, and those are the things that will eat you up as a staff is when you get those opportunities to get that stop, get a long rebound, and possibly push in a little bit of transition, at least get a secondary look, and it goes right into the hand of an opposing player, and they get a wide-open shot out of it.
So 61-49 is the Florida College lead. We pause for a moment. Faulkner Sports Network. Email comes in from Jenny Colson, says, great streaming coverage once again. Colson family battling the flu but watching from home again today. Go Eagles, let's win this one. I'm with you there, Jenny. We're going to get a whistle on this end. We'll see what they choose to call this one. They'll put that one on Moore.
It's four for her.
It's four on her. So you've got two Lady Falcons with four fouls. You got three with three fouls. Inbound, Gafford up over the defense, and Channing Gafford rises up. 61-50, 7-11 to go here in the fourth. Faulkner needing to put stops and shots together here. Varnell attacks, kicks to Moore. Thought about it, got it over to Judy. Judy, Canyon, three, no. Rebound, alive, and a foul going to be called, I think, on Colson here.
Yeah.
That's going to be four on Colson if it is. It is, so four on Liv Colson. Colson's got 10 points, 5 boards, and an assist as she goes to the bench. Inbound comes to Judy. Ball fake, throws it across to Moore, wide open three, won't go. Rebound and a foul. They're going to go over the back, I think, against Varnell.
That's four on her if
that's
it is.
That's four on Varnell. So Everett, Moore, and Varnell all playing with four fouls.
And now Faulkner with free throw trips here for the remainder of the ball game.
And that's if you're gonna cut into this double digit deficit and get it back into a winnable situation, got to convert these because the count's in their favor. Wilkinson misses that one. Wilkinson looking for her first point of the day. That one misses. Tipped alive. Faulkner can't gather the rebound, so it's an empty trip this time. We'll go the other way. Canyon across the timeline, defended by Wilkinson. Works it over left wing Moore. Moore face up with Atkins, sends it out to Henson. Henson, Canyon on the deck, works it around. And can't get that to go. Nice recovery by Channing Gafford there. Atkins pushes the issue. All the way into the defense, and they're going to get that one, I think, on Canyon. We'll see. No, they may go Judy. No, they go Canyon.
Just two for Canyon.
Two on her. So Atkins to the line. She's got 9 points. Make it 10. That'll cut it to 9. Second one, Atkins good. 61-53 is the score. Inbound comes into the corner to Varnell. Varnell throws it ahead to Henson. Henson all the way over, kicks it out. That shot good by Judy. 63-53, Atkins into the front court. She hands the ball off Wilkinson. Wilkinson to Gafford. Gafford pulls it. Good. That'll cut it to 7. And almost got the steal off the inbound. Fasanic got to recover. Wilkinson slows it down and allows her to. 7-point deficit. Lady Eagles looking for stops and shots. Varnell working to her right. Gets it into the hand of Judy. Judy back over to Varnell. Varnell defended by Wilkinson, goes down into the corner to Canyon. Canyon kicks out. Moore misses it. Rebound, Clocker. She'll pass it ahead to Gafford. Gafford will bring it back around. Into the corner, Wilkinson. She'll attack, kick, Atkins, deep three. Count it, Splashlin Atkins. That cuts it to 4. Fasanic defending, and you're going to get a timeout from Florida College. So you get a 4-point deficit, 5:04 to go, but the momentum clearly has swung back to the home team.
If shifted back that direction, and they're defending a little better on the other end. They've had a couple of instances where they've rotated and over-rotated a little bit and given up those deep looks, but they've been able to get those misses and then get the ball and go the other direction with them, and it's led to that secondary three by Gafford and then the movement and able to get that for Atkins here on this last trip.
63-59, 5:04 to go. And look, the foul situation is what Merritt's watching right now. Faulkner's shooting two the rest of the way. And you've got three Florida College players with 4 fouls, 2 others with 3 fouls.
Yeah.
For Faulkner, Liv Colson's got 4, Channing Gafford's got 3, Michaela Fasonic's got 3.
And you've just got to keep putting your head down and attacking the lane.
And that's been the big difference in this fourth quarter. they were shooting 18% from three coming into the fourth quarter. They stopped attempting those and started attacking and then created a shot, a look for Ashlyn Atkins.
If you keep putting your head down, getting into the teeth of that defense, they're going to collapse, and you're going to be able to kick out and rotate and get those open looks from three.
Kanyon comes into the front court, defended by Harbin. Works it over left side, Varnell. She'll put it on the deck. Back over to Moore. Moore, defended by Atkins, gets it back to Varnell. Varnell off screen from Moore. There's Moore attacking baseline, kicks it. Kanyon, three, no. Long rebound and a whistle away from the ball. Who are they putting that one on?
It's going to be on Lauren Moore.
That's five. Lauren Moore is fouled out. That is a valuable player for Florida College, and Lauren Moore, who averages 9 points a game. But David Turner, when you look at Lauren Moore, she was a 74% free throw shooter out of 94 attempts, so that's somebody who gets to the line and knows what to do once she gets there. She's also their second leading rebounder at 7.4 a game. She's fouled out.
Yeah, and again, you go back to it, but it's important at this point of the game, right back at the free throw line, a chance to cut this to 2 points.
11-2 is the Faulkner run. They cut it to three. Got to get a stop on this end. Harbin defending Kanyon. Kanyon gets it to Everett. She's got a lane to the basket. Right hand won't go. Tipped alive. Fight on the floor. Kanyon's got it. She'll slow things down. Reset at 18 on the shot clock. Goes all the way in, and Clocker gets there, but they're going to get somebody with a foul. They're going to get Harbin with it. That's three or two on Harbin. Two on Kayla Harbin. Kanyon to the line. Hits the first one. 4 point Florida College lead. 5 point Florida College lead. Kanyon's now got 8 points. Five boards, four assists. Good all around day for her. Atkins ahead to Fasani. Fasani puts it on the deck. Left, back, right. Now left again. Kicks it. Clocker swings it. Atkins to Fasonic. Pulls that three and knocks it down. Mickey Fizz. She's got 16. I think that's one off her career high. Into the front court comes Varnell. Varnell misses the shot. Rebound underneath by Harbin. Faulkner down two with the ball. 3:41 to go. Fasonic. Working to the right, she'll attack all the way in. Layup, won't go. Rebound, Harbin. Kicks it out, Atkins. Three, count it, splash it, Atkins. Faulkner has taken the lead after having been down 11. Atkins with 18.
It's all predicated on that attack by Fasonic getting to the rim, and then it comes down to an offensive rebound and an open three for Atkins.
Varnell working to the right, defended by Fasonic. She kicks it over left side, Everett. Everett attacks, mid-range, pulls it back out. Judy runs into Atkins.
It's going to be a block on Atkins.
They're going to call a block on Atkins. That would have been four on Judy.
It's the first on Atkins.
66-65. So they get the blocking foul on Atkins. The next one will put Florida College at the line. Throws it into Judy. Pulls the three. Won't go. Fasonic with the board. Faulkner with the lead and the ball. 2:57 to play. Atkins into the front court. Gets it over to Colson. Colson back over to Fasonic. She works to her left. Now attacks all the way. Fasonic pulls it. New career high for Mickey Fizz. She's got 18. Faulkner with a three-point lead.
Fasonic not settling for anything there offensively. He wants to get right to that bucket.
Varnell attacks right, kicks it into the corner. Back up top, that's Henson. She'll go all the way in, and what a move by Henson to lay it in left hand on the scoop. Cuts it to one. Atkins into the front court. Gafford back over right wing Harbin. There's Atkins, dumps it down low. Hands it off to Gafford, does Colson. Right back to Colson. She spins, kicks, Harbin. Thought about it. Back over. Gafford, three. Rattles over the top but won't go in, and that may be five on Liv Coulson. We'll see what they call here. That's on Liv Coulson. She is done for the day. I would imagine that'll get Meg Wilkinson in here. Coulson's day is over. 10 points, 5 boards, and an assist. Megan Wilkinson will come in. And that'll put Henson on the line shooting two.
She's trying to walk off a little bit of an ankle. Coulson came down, rolled right over her ankle, so they're giving her a little time to walk that off.
10 points, 7 boards, 2 assists right now for Henson. She goes to the line, a chance to tie it. Now the best she can do is tie it as she misses the first one. Second free throw coming from Henson. Back iron, no good. She missed them both. Gafford with the rebound. She'll bring it across the timeline. They'll set up the offense. Harbin all the way in, kicks it back out. Wilkinson rotates it to Gafford. 1:48 to play, 19 on the shot clock. Harbin with it, dumps it to Atkins as she attacks. Back over, can't bank it in. Rebound Everett. Florida College down one with the ball, 1:35 to play. Varnell all the way in, layup good. Florida College retakes the lead with 1.5 to go. Atkins across the timeline, gets it to Harbin. Into the corner to Wilkinson, back up to Fasanic. Fasanic pulls the three. Yes, forget the Instagram takeovers. It's a Tyne Davis takeover from Michaela Fasanic. 71-69, a new career high, 21 for her. There's the attack to the right for Varnell. Sends it over. Three from Everett. Right back up top goes Florida College. It's a fourth quarter that's turned into a prize fight here as they're trading back and forth, and we're going to get a whistle to stop it.
Get together, Chan. That must be. You got to close that. You got to close that.
57 seconds on the clock. They'll reset it to 59.5. 30 seconds left in the game. Faulkner down one. Canyon will come defend Atkins all the way out. Make her give it up to Harbin. And Canyon will stay with Atkins all the way, and there's
a
foul on Judy.
It's going to be four on Judy.
Four on Judy. To the line will go Kayla Harbin. 4.7 boards, 2 assists right now for Harbin as she steps to the line, down 1:52.7 to play. First free throw, no good. Needs the second one to tie it here. Second free throw coming from Kayla Harbin. Up and good. Tie game, 52.7 to play. And David Turner with that will take our final break for this broadcast. Nope. We'll keep it here. Listen. The attack was working in the fourth quarter. It freed up the three-point shot. Faulkner has now outscored Florida College 27-16 this quarter, and we got a tie game.
And you came into the quarter shooting 18% from three. You're now at 32%.
Just like that. So I think 5 threes made this quarter, because I think it was 4 of 22.
I think you're right. And it's all come from that attack mentality. Drive inside, collapse the defense, and work the ball back out. And you, if you rotate offensively, you're going to find those soft spots in that defense and be able to get the open looks. And that's what we've seen so many of these looks come off of, except for the last couple, especially the last one where Fasanic just staring the defender right down the eye and puts it up and knocks it down cold-blooded. But
yeah, Mickey Fizz with a ball game here. But as is, we talk about the offensive end, and obviously you got to get the good possessions and get shots. But you got to get a stop.
Yeah, right now you've got to get a stop. You've got to lock in defensively. You've got to rotate, communicate with one another, and not give up those slow closeouts defensively to give up an open shot.
Varnell with it, face up with Fasonic. There's a 22-second differential between shot and game. Canyon with it. She attacks all the way, muscles it up, won't go, tip out. Canyon chases it down, and out of bounds. Faulkner gets the stop. 7-second differential between shot and game now. 72-all, 37 seconds to play. Adkins will come across the timeline. Hand it off to Harbin. Gets it to Gafford. Dumps it to Maya Gaston. Turn around, goes up, won't drop. Shot clock is off. Everett with a basketball. Sends it over to Canyon and a timeout with 18.2 to play. Faulkner's got to try to hold on with 18 seconds left. See if you can get a shot at the end or go to overtime.
Yeah, Gaston had a pretty good look down on the other end. I think it was deflected coming out of her hand.
Yeah.
Which made that a difficult shot. But now you've got to really lock in defensively. Nobody gets a foot away from you. You've got to stay with your offensive player and try to lock this possession down. Just one possession, because I would imagine Florida College is going to use as much of this clock as they possibly can. And then hope for the best on the other side.
72-all, 18.2 to play. We'll get the inbound, see what Florida College is drawing up. The five for Faulkner, Fasonic, Gafford, Adkins, Harbin, Gaston. For Florida College, Varnell, Everett, Canyon, Judy, and there she is, Henson. They're not defending the inbound there. Instead, they're going to come double Judy up top. 14 to play. Canyon with it. 10 to play. She's got a clear out. 6 to play. She'll attack. Rotates over. Right hand won't go. Rebound. Can't get a put back up. We're going to overtime here at Tyne Davis. A 27-16 fourth quarter for Faulkner. Forces overtime. Let's catch our breath. Faulkner Sports Network. We go to overtime here at Tyne Davis, 72-all. Faulkner with a 27-point fourth quarter to force overtime. We'll see if they can keep the offense rolling. It's Clocker, Fasonic, Harbin, Gafford, Adkins to start. Henson, Varnell, Canyon, Judy, and I think Everett. Yep, that's the five for Florida College. Varnell controls it after the tip. They'll send it over right side, Judy. Back over to Henson. Henson attacks, kicks, Varnell, three, no. Rebound, Fasonic. Fasonic across the timeline. She's taking over, running the offense, tells Clocker what to do on the clear out. She'll go all the way to the basket. The hesitation dribble. Mickey Fizz banks it in and out. That's not a bad look.
It's not, and it's getting exactly what you want to do, because still, you've got to remember how many Florida College players have four fouls.
Yeah. There's Judy with it. She's one of those with four fouls.
It's a nice pass underneath.
Judy, rebound, fought for. Loose ball. Atkins will pick up the foul as she runs into Henson. Henson taking a beating, and Atkins slow to get up. Atkins will get up. They easily could have put number five on Judy when she collided with Gafford in that loose ball. You got to be glad, though, honestly, in overtime you let him play in those situations. 73-72. Henson, second free throw. It's good. Florida College retakes the lead. 74-72. Atkins into the front court. She'll work to the left, hand off Gafford. Gafford all the way in, muscles it up and in. Jenna Gafford ties the game. She's got 18.
Strong take by Gafford right to the front of the rim. As Judy was on her, she has four fouls, so she's looking to attack, be aggressive, and make the referees put them in a difficult situation. Judy travels right there.
Clocker closed out just enough to make Judy think about it, and she drugged that foot. 74 all, 3:40 to go in overtime. Inbound comes to Atkins. Hands it off to Gafford. Ball fake. All the way in. Muscles it up. It won't go. Rebound fought for. Judy's got it. Several near misses for the Lady Eagles late. Judy in. Kicks. Everett. Jumper won't go. Atkins rebounds it. That was an agonizing miss as it hung on the rim. Gafford up. Scoops it under. And a foul. So Channing Gafford to the line. Do not even mention her achievements at the line today. You and your bad juju.
That's what I do, apparently.
That is what you do. 74 all, 3:11 to play. Gafford, 18 points right now. She steps to the line. First free throw up and good for Gafford. 75-74. Second free throw forthcoming for the junior wing. Up, no good. Rebound Clocker gets it back out of there to Fasonic. An extra possession courtesy of Valentina Clocker. Kicks it over to Harbin. Harbin over to Gafford. Gafford down to Clocker. Could have easily gotten a foul on Henson there. Clocker out to Fasonic, three to shoot. She'll put it up. It won't hit the rim. It'll be a shot clock violation. They burn an extra 20 seconds off of it due to the extra possession. They'll set up the press. Really full court man-to-man here.
Just make Florida College take a little time off the clock, getting it up.
Varnell defended by Fasonic. Everett nearly loses it out of bounds. She gathers, closed out by Atkins. There's Judy working against Clocker. She'll throw that one up, no good. Kind of a wild look. Fasonic comes out of there with it. She'll bring it across the timeline. Works it over left side, Gafford. Back over to Harbin. Harbin. Right, back, left, all the way in. Muscles it up and a foul. If it's Everett, that's five. It is on Henson.
That's her second.
Third.
Third.
So three on Henson.
I saw it right after you said that.
Free throw from Harbin. Back iron, no good. Second free throw from Kayla Harbin. Faulkner needing this to make it a two-point lead. We'll see what Harbin does here. The senior comes set, shoots, and it's good. 76-74. Faulkner will set up the press. They will force the ball away from Varnell. Canyon will bring it up. She'll head out, kick it out to Henson. Henson all the way in, kicks, Judy, three, yes. That's the first three they've made in a while, but it gives them a one-point lead with a 1:53 to go in overtime. Adkins with it, kicks it over. There's Gafford. She'll pull it up, free throw line. It won't go. Not the best possession for the Lady Eagles. And a foul.
Foul's going to be on Harbin.
Free throw coming from Judy. That one misses.
I need a rebound. Ask him.
That one goes. 78-76. Adkins into the front court, finds Harbin wide open underneath, and a tie game again. Adkins with a good look as Harbin flashes open. That's five assists for Adkins. Varnell with it. She'll work to the right, leave it for Judy. 78 all, a minute 19 to go. Judy stuck on the pivot foot, gets it to Varnell. Varnell backs it out, eight to shoot. She attacks left, gives it up to Canyon. Jumper won't go, rebound fought for, Gafford's got it. Faulkner with the ball, a minute to go in overtime in a tie game. Gets Clocker streaking ahead. Valentina Clocker with a layup off the Gafford look.
Great look.
80-78.
Great look ahead by Gafford. Good job by Clocker just continuing to run the floor, being patient, waiting for that pass to come.
Fasonic defends Varnell. Varnell throws it out of bounds. Faulkner gets the turnover. Faulkner gets the turnover. 39.9 to go in overtime. Two-point lead, and Faulkner's got the ball. Adkins catches it. No need to be in a hurry here if you're the Lady Eagles. Leaves it for Fasonic. Hands it off to Gafford. There it is to Adkins. Lane to the basket. Kick out to Clocker. Back to Gafford. There's Fasonic resetting. 14 to shoot. She'll leave it for Clocker. All the way. Clocker with the take. Valentina Clocker's going to win it for the Lady Eagles in overtime. Oh, my. 15 seconds to go. Judy over to Everett. The three air balls. Henson underneath, and she's fouled.
Strong, aggressive take by Clocker on the other end. That foul is going to be on Kayla Harbin. That's four for her.
David Turner, you talked about it. Coming out of the third quarter, zero bench points for Faulkner as a team. Now they have six, and they're all off the hand of Valentina Clocker. Four of them are the last two buckets here in overtime. 82-78, 8.6 to play. Going to get a full timeout. We'll keep it right here. It's the transition bucket.
Yeah.
That got them, and then Clocker, as they're running clock, pulls that defense out because Faulkner's not eager to and they even passed up one open lane.
They did.
And that Florida College defense pulls out and cleared some space, and Clocker took it from the wing.
Yeah, they're running a weave, just a little weave up here to use the clock and get their three best ball handlers really with the opportunity to touch the basketball and finally get Clocker back down that corner. And she just makes the aggressive move right across the lane with that sweeping layup, put the Lady Eagles back up four.
82-78, 8.6 to go in the game.
The key's going to be after these two free throws, especially if the last one's a make, you're going to have some kind of press coming to try to get a steal. You've got to be prepared for that and ready to go and
right.
Know that it's coming.
And we talked about that against Bruton Parker Thursday night, the way Faulkner passed through that press
and
didn't turn the ball over. That's a real sign of growth here. And if they make this free throw, like you said, you got to know that's coming. Free throw misses. The best she can do is cut it to a one-possession game here. Henson.
Box out huge here now for the Lady Eagles.
misses it. Rebound Clocker, and she gets the timeout immediately. Valentina Clocker grabs the rebound. That is her fifth, and she immediately calls timeout. 7.7 to go, 4-point game here in overtime.
It's a great job by Coach Sutton having them be aware of the situation, grab the rebound, immediately call a timeout, don't wait for the foul and all that kind of thing where you can get the players you want in because you know a foul's coming, get your best free throw shooters on the floor where you're prepared for the situation.
82-78, 7.7 to go. And if you're Sutton, as you talked about here, best free throw shooters, best ball handlers, no turnovers.
I wouldn't be surprised if it's an all-guard lineup plus Gafford.
Who functionally at times is a guard. So
she is.
This is a huge one for the Lady Eagles today. They've been up against it in this losing streak in a funk. And they were down 11 in the fourth quarter. No quit in this ball club today. Ashlyn Atkins will inbound it to Gafford. Gets it back to Atkins. She'll take the contact and the foul. She'll go to the line.
Foul comes with 5.8 remaining in the ball game.
5.8 to go in overtime. Atkins, 18 points to her credit so far. Give her 19. Second free throw coming. Makes it. It's a 6-point lead. 5.8 to play. Wilkinson defends Varnell. She'll bring it across. That'll do it. She'll heave it. It won't go. And Faulkner with a massive, massive fourth quarter and overtime. Over the final 15 minutes of play, this is a Faulkner ball club that scored 39 points. 27 in the fourth quarter and 12 in overtime for the win. 84-78. Big, big win for Faulkner as they break the losing streak and remind themselves of just what they're capable of.
Yeah, and big win all the way around, and it's one of those things where you're down 11.
Absolutely.
And it's one of those situations that can give you a lot of confidence going forward, knowing that, hey, we've come from down 11 against a very scrappy Florida College team, a team that does a lot of things really well, and you find yourself able to claw your way back into that game and get a win right here in conference where it matters the most.
And so the Lady Eagles final here, 84-78. Look at these percentages. Faulkner got that field goal percentage all the way up to 42%.
And dropped Florida College's percentage down to 38.
Yeah.
They were shooting roughly 45% for a chunk of the ball game.
Faulkner, who was shooting 18% from three after the third quarter, hit 5 threes in the fourth quarter to get that percentage all the way up to 32%. They make 17 out of 27 free throws. They win the rebounding battle 42-39. But you talked about it, David. After the third quarter, zero bench points for Faulkner. They end up with 6 points off the bench, all of them from Valentina Clocker. Four of them were the final two field goals of overtime, including what would prove to be the game winner. Big play out of her after Liv Colson fouled out. And this is a Faulkner team that you wonder who's going to carry the scoring burden. Well, today it was every starter. 21 points for Michaela Fasanica, career high. 20 for Ashlyn Atkins. 19 for Channing Gafford. 10 for Liv Colson and 8 for Kayla Harbin. That's a heck of a performance.
It is. And one of the things that they find themselves in now, that they're in a situation where they can have that opportunity to where on any given night it could be player X. It doesn't have to be one player, but it can be several different players any given night, and that's one of the situations that they find themselves in, and it's just taking that opportunity and building the confidence to go out and do it. And I think we saw Fasanik do a lot of good things tonight, just looking to attack, looking for her shot, looking for those opportunities to get to the basket, and she did a great job with that.
And you have not at any point in her career seen her as confident as she was in that fourth quarter when she takes the ball and directs the offense and requests the clear out and attacks the basket and then takes it off the three. And it's not a hesitation, like, I guess I'll take this open look. She wanted that look.
Yeah.
That's the Michaela Fasanik that if that one shows up the rest of the way and Gafford and Atkins continue to do what they do, this is a team that can play with anybody and beat anybody in this league.
They are. And you look at the rebounding numbers that Faulkner out-rebounds Florida College today, and that's been a problem since Angela Grant's gone down. So you win that battle. Again, that's another check in the confidence pile that, hey, we can as a team go out and rebound with anybody. We can go get those rebounds and those loose balls. So another little confidence building block that they've got here from this afternoon.
So a big win in overtime for Faulkner. Again, they score 39 points in the fourth quarter in overtime to erase what was an 11-point deficit, and we alluded to it at the time. They had 11-point leads in the fourth quarter in multiple losses during this losing streak. Today, they flip the script and turn an 11-point deficit into a win. For David Turner, Carter Moles, Overton Gates, Deshaun Bullock, Jacob Hartsfield, and Austin Hyde, I am Jeremy Smith. This has been the Faulkner Sports Network presentation of Faulkner Eagle Lady Basketball. Good night, and God bless you.